I'm sure we've all heard this familiar noise before and are already thinking about going and grabbing one for ourselves. One can of Coca-Cola has 39 grams of sugar and 140 calories from that sugar. A small, so delicious drink has anywhere from 40 to 50 grams of sugar. And let's be honest, nobody gets the small. I'm sure we all know that soda isn't healthy, but we probably don't realize just how bad for our health it really is. As an exercise and wellness major and fiend for water, I've taken my fair share of nutrition and health classes, as well as doing my own personal research. Obesity and chronic illnesses are rapidly increasing in our society, and we need to be educated on how, on what things contribute to them. Drinking soda is one of the worst things for our bodies, and steps should be taken to decrease the amount of soda we drink. Consuming beverages with added sugar, like soda, contributes to weight gain, high blood sugar, and increased heart disease risk. The sugar in soda is liquid sugar, meaning we drink it and don't have to chew it. Liquid sugar is not only easier to consume, it is also worse for your body. In an article titled "The Harms of Liquid Sugar" by Francisca Spritzler, a registered dietitian, she explains that the body doesn't register liquid sugar calories the same way it does solid sugar calories. So you are more likely to consume an excess amount of calories when drinking sugary drinks. These excess calories and sugar inevitably lead to weight gain. Diabetes continues to rise, especially in youth, as the number of people who are overweight or obese also rises. Dr. James DiNicolantonio conducted a study for Mayo Clinic that concluded consuming added sugars may be the greatest cause for incident diabetes. The World Health Organization says there is no need for added sugars in the diet and to try and reduce our intake to 5% of total calories. This value has been shown to decrease the prevalence of diabetes and the metabolic derangements that accompany it. For a 2,000 calorie diet, which is probably close to what most of us eat, that means only consuming 100 calories of added sugar, which is less than a can of Coke that contains 140 calories. It is important for ourselves and the rising generations that we are cognizant of how much processed sugar we are putting into our bodies. And the regular consumption of soda is the easiest way to get too much. Cardiovascular disease, or heart disease, is the number one cause of death in the United States. And even more shocking than that, 80% of those deaths are preventable through lifestyle changes, the biggest being maintaining a healthy weight and diet. Dr. Stan Hope, a research nutritional biologist, published a study in the Journal of Nutrition on the effects of consuming high amounts of fructose. High amounts of fructose in sweetened beverages leads to increased lipids in the blood, which can cause clogged arteries as well as an increase in visceral adipose tissue, both of which increase your risk of heart disease. These results were not only found in people who were insulin resistant or had obesity. A clinical trial also done by Dr. Stan Hope and some of his colleagues for the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition found that healthy men with a moderate weight had an increase in heart health markers and an increased risk of cardiovascular disease associated with consuming many beverages with added sugar. So as you can see, drinking soda can do some pretty harmful things to your body, like promoting weight gain, which can lead to the development of diabetes or even heart disease. Next time you reach for a soda, think about what it could mean for your future and try to find an alternative. Some of my favorite alternatives are sparkling waters, like AHA, specifically the blueberry and pomegranate flavor, or Waterloo. If you want a healthier soda alternative, these naturally sweetened Zevia drinks are also great. It can be hard to cut back on something that may be a part of your daily life, but the sooner you can, the healthier you will be.